Alright, I'm gonna be shooting my DIY video, just the oil change on a 2004 Chevy Tahoe. First thing we're gonna start off with, simply removing the oil cap that we found here. Alright. Now, once you get your oil cap off, you can go ahead and get in position to start jacking up the vehicle. Okay. All right, so I like to do jack the vehicle up in the middle of the vehicle and then place my jack stands on the sides. This vehicle, I'm going to use truck jack stands. Send the work done because it's rich high level. Same thing on the opposite side. And now we're ready to go underneath and drain the oil out. All right, now we got the vehicle backed up and secured. The jack stands come in and begin to drain the oil. Pretty simple process. It's a 15 millimeter bolt. Okay, it's on there pretty good. I don't need to fight it. I'm using a 3/8 wrench. I just grab something a little bit bigger. looks like it was probably over tightened by the last person that did the oil change. So I'm gonna use a half drive just to make it simple. And I'll just use this to loosen it. Switch back over to my 3/8 now. I don't need it. And it should be set. I want to position this. This is loose. Just going to twist it. There we go. All coming down. That's draining. You can take note that the oil filter is right over here on the other side, closer to the driver's side. Should be hand tight and hand loosened, but I do have an oil wrench just in case. So once I get the oil where it's not draining out so far away from the filter, I'll begin to loosen up the filter. Be close enough. There we go. Put a little turn on it. Loosen it up with my hand, let it start to drip down. I'm seeing that my drain plug is pretty much just this really slow drip, so I know I got all my oil out of there. I can go ahead and start reinstalling my drain plug. Again, just a 3/8 drive to tighten it down a little bit. You don't want to overdo it. Might strip the bolts. And then you got a whole big problem. Alright, so now that my oil filter drip is slowing down, go ahead and twist that off. New filter. Just come back on the opposite side. Easier to reach. When you replace the filter, you want to take just a little dab of the old oil and put it around the seal. This helps the filter seal properly. And from there, just twist it back up there. So the oil filter is simply hand tighten, hand loosen. So you gotta do it using the rack so I can get a better grip on it. And just twist it on with my hand as tight as I can get it. And that secures the filter. That's it. You wanna clean away all the excess oil that made a drip down on the side of the engine and whatnot, and you're pretty much done on the bottom side. Alright, now I'm going to go ahead and remove the jack stands. We're going to jack it up a little bit. Enough to get the weight off the jack stands. Should hear it release. What you do, pull the lever. Remove it. Same thing on the opposite side. That point, ready to add your oil in. Oh. We put the left truck down. All right, next step is the oil. I'm going to go ahead and use a wide funnel. Nobody here make the model, you know that this one takes 6 quarts of oil. I'm going to add in 10 to 30 just to run something a little thicker. Again, this is oil change on the 2004 Chevy Tahoe. 5.3 liter engine, and it's going to take 6 quarts of oil.
that is pretty much it. Get your funnel out, get it cleaned up. Make sure you replace the oil cap. After that, you want to pour the dipstick. Just the yellow one right here. Clean it off. And then make sure, put it back in, and then you check your oil level and make sure you have the right amount. Perfect. That's it. Okay, the last step in the oil change is you wanna reset your oil life light, okay? So what you're gonna do is turn the key to the on position. And then it's gonna be a little button that looks like a little gas, a little gas can or gas station symbol right here. You're gonna press that until you go to oil light. So I'll try to fix the lighter. There we go. Okay, so now there, you want to press that so you see oil life 13%. Now then, you're going to press the arrow here. All right, go back, this arrow. Press that arrow and hold it. There you go. Oil life reset, 100%. And then you can turn off the key. And you're done. And the last thing you want to do is dispose of your oil properly. My way of doing it is take the old container that the oil came out of, like the funnel over there, and then just pour it back into the same container that it came out of. And you can just take it back to the parts store that you got it from, or any parts store, AutoZone, O'Reilly, Advance, all of them. You can take it back to them and dispose of the oil properly. Once you do that, you are all done. Thanks for tuning in. My first DIY video. Hopefully I get a lot more. Get a lot of viewers and subscribers.